A look at recent developments in the South China Sea, where China is pitted against smaller neighbors in multiple territorial disputes over islands, coral reefs, and lagoons. The waters are a major shipping route for global commerce and are rich in fish and possible oil and gas reserves. The U.S. Navy says the aircraft carrier Ronald Reagan and its strike group entered the South China Sea earlier this month and have been carrying out air operations. The Nimitz and Ronald Reagan carrier strike groups picked up high-end dual carrier exercises in the South China Sea again. A move that comes after the U.S. said Beijing's claims to offshore resources across most of the South China Sea are completely unlawful. Together, the carriers and their strike groups are partaking in tactical air defense exercises to maintain warfighting readiness and proficiency. Nimitz and Reagan carrier strike groups are operating in the South China Sea, wherever international law allows, to reinforce our commitment to a free and open Indo-Pacific, a rules-based international order, and to our allies and partners in the region. Security and stability is essential to peace and prosperity for all nations, and it is for that reason the U.S. Navy has been present and ready in the Pacific for over 75 years. Carrier strike groups and an Air Force B-52 Stratofortress from Barksdale Air Force Base in Louisiana conducted a maritime integration exercise in the South China Sea. That iteration of exercises was launched and each carrier strike group continued on its respective operational tasking. The Navy said placing the carriers in the South China Sea is not a reaction to any political or global event. Instead, the exercises are routine operations designed to foster tactical operability. Even so, the most recent exercise follows the U.S. rejection Monday of most of China's claims in the South China Sea. That's a change from the status quo, where the U.S. resisted wading into maritime disputes between China and other countries in the region and called for peaceful solutions. The world will not allow Beijing to treat the South China Sea as its maritime empire. America stands with our Southeast Asian allies and partners in protecting their sovereign rights to offshore resources, consistent with their rights and obligations under international law. United States stand with the international community in defense of freedom of the seas and respect for sovereignty and reject any push to impose might makes right in the South China Sea or the wider region. China routinely objects to U.S. naval activity in the sea, especially when more than one strike group is present, as happened earlier this year, and when they involve operations with navies from other countries. The strike group includes the carrier, its air wing, the guided missile cruiser USS Antietam, and the destroyers USS Mustin and USS Rafael Peralta. The force conducted flight operations with fixed and rotary wing aircraft, and high-end maritime stability operations and exercises, its commander said in a news release. Operations in the South China Sea continue to demonstrate enduring U.S. commitment to allies and partners, and the cooperative approach to regional stability and freedom of the seas. China is holding another round of military drills in the South China Sea amid an uptick in such activity in the area, highlighting growing tensions. U.S. Permanent Representative to the United Nations has fired back at Chinese territorial claims in the South China Sea. Ambassador Kelly Craft's note weighs in on Malaysia's behalf in its bid to reject China-imposed limits on its continental shelf allowing it rights to resources. The United States rejects these maritime claims as inconsistent with international law as reflected in the 1982 Law of the Sea Convention. The U.S. does not officially take a stand on sovereignty issues in the area, but maintains its military has the right to fly, sail and operate in all areas open to international navigation. The Maritime Safety Administration said the exercises would run from Monday through Sunday. It warned outside vessels to steer 5 nautical miles clear of the drill area but otherwise gave no details. China announced late last month that it had held drills in the South China Sea involving long-range bombers and other aircraft. Chinese forces have also confronted U.S. naval vessels conducting freedom of navigation operations near Chinese-held islands, as well as forces from Australia and countries that challenge China's claim to the entire strategic waterway.